So you want to plant wildflowers for bees. That's great. Wildflower plantings provide bees with food and shelter and help their populations survive and grow. But how do you go from this to this? It's not quite as simple as just sowing some seeds. Preparing the area you want to plant is essential for getting a good-looking, abundant, diverse stand of wildflowers that will provide the best possible support for wild and managed bees. In this video, we'll go over the 5 steps to success for establishing a native perennial wildflower planting for pollinators. Step 1. Pick a good site. Step 2. Kill the weeds before seeding. Step 3. Choose the right seed mix. Step 4. Seed it well. Step 5. Kill the weeds after seeding. Step 1. Pick a good site. You may be limited to whatever space you have available to you, but if you have some choices, here are some things to think about. You want a site that's sunny and fairly well drained. Take a look at what weeds are present. Are they going to be particularly challenging to control before seeding? If the answer to this is yes, your wildflowers may have a difficult time establishing there, so choose a site with a weed bank that will be easier to manage. Make sure your site is protected from pesticide drift from farm fields. If your pollinator habitat will be close to a treated area, consider planting a vegetative drift barrier like the one shown here. Step 2. Kill the weeds before seeding. Most sites are going to require at least one full season of careful weed eradication before you seed. This is super critical. Without good control of each new flush of weeds throughout the growing season, your native wildflowers will not establish well because they won't be able to outcompete weedy plants for sunlight, water, and nutrients. Killing weeds is most effective and least costly if you do it before you seed in wildflowers that you would then need to avoid. There are many different options for site preparation depending on the equipment, time, and other limitations you might have. Some are more effective than others. We will be doing how-to videos on a few different chemical and non-chemical weed control strategies, so subscribe to our channel if you'd like to be the first to know about those. Step 3. Choose the right seed mix. We recommend planting species that are native to your area, as they're more likely to be adapted to local conditions and pollinators. Choose species that fit the type of site that you'll be planting. If you're planting in a dry, sandy site, pick species that will do well in these types of conditions, or vice versa if you're planting in heavy clay soils with lots of moisture. You want a mix designed with bees in mind. That means a mix of species that will provide continuous bloom throughout the season. Make sure to include plants that are known to provide good resources for pollinators. If you need help choosing plants or determining seeding rates for the different species in the mix, there are lots of resources available online to help you out. For more, consult with your local cooperative extension, farm advisor, or native plant nursery to determine the right mix for your site. Once you've prepared a site and have your seed mix on hand, step 4 is to seed the site well. How do you seed? Just like with weed control, there are different options for seeding. You can broadcast seed by hand or with a handheld broadcast seeder, or use a tractor-pulled drop seeder or no-till drill. We'll cover different methods of seeding in an upcoming video. The important thing is to spread seed evenly across the site and to make sure the seeds are getting good contact with the soil surface. To ensure even seed distribution, you can mix your small, light wildflower seeds with a bulking agent, such as sawdust or coarse sand, to help add volume for broadcasting the seed over a large area. After seeding, lightly roll over the seeds with a cultipacker or lawn roller to help ensure good seed-to-soil contact for germination. The best timing for seeding can vary by region, as well as by the method you use to prepare the site and control weeds. Perennial wildflower seeds are sown during the dormant season, typically in late fall. Some wildflower species require exposure to moist, cold conditions in order to germinate. If you're seeding in early spring, some seeds may need to be cold stratified for a few weeks prior to seeding. The final step to success is killing the weeds. Weed control is important enough to get 2 steps. After seeding, you'll need to monitor the planting for major weed issues. In some regions, like the Midwest, this means mowing the planting in the first year to keep annual and biennial weeds from going to seed. Mow to boot height every time the vegetation reaches calf height. This will keep weeds from raining seed into the planting and will allow sunlight to penetrate down to where the perennial wildflowers are establishing roots. In some cases, it can make sense to hand pull or spot spray areas with problem weeds. This is best done when weed species are smaller, as pulling larger plants can bring new seeds to the surface and disturb growing wildflower seedlings. Make sure you can tell the difference between weed species and wildflower seedlings before hand pulling or spot treating weeds. So, to sum up, the 5 steps to success are 1. Pick a good site. 2. Kill the weeds before seeding. 3. Choose the right seed mix. 4. Seed it well. And 5. Kill the weeds after seeding. If you follow these steps, you'll end up with great pollinator habitat. Perennial wildflowers generally take at least a year to establish. If your planting looks messy in the first year, don't worry, that's normal. With good site preparation and weed management, the planting will begin to fill in by year 2, and by the 3rd year will be a bloom-rich pollinator refuge. For more information on our ongoing research on crop pollination, wildflower plantings, and more, visit our website at www.projecticp.org.